John Gardner, head of the GTHL, send me that. This is Dan Cameron's Junior Canadians. Last year they won the ban of them all. They win everything every year. They won the GTHL and they won the OHL Cup. And this is John McFarland, the captain, who I predict will be number one in the draft. You'll all be telling me about him. Zach Sapiro, Scott Somerville, and Tyler Toffoli. Toffoli. You know, something like that. Let me tell you some other guys that are in this, that were in this. Now, the top drafts, eh? We're going to talk about Drew Doughty, Alexander Pietrangelo, John Tavares played, Steve Stamkos, and my favorite, Taylor Hall. Just thought I'd throw that in.
Hey, before we get to the Jonathan Roy, Patrick Roy story,
yes.
Question for you. Toronto Maple Leafs, Phoenix Coyotes, the Florida Panthers had won six in a row. The Edmonton Oilers are in tough, got an outside chance still ahead tonight. But what happened to those teams, Don, in your opinion, that were going good and all of a sudden out?
Well, I've seen this happen before. Here's what happens. The players don't change. The coaches change. And here's what happened. The atmosphere in the dressing room, we're out of it. Let's play the kids. We got nothing to lose. Just go out, have a good time. And that's what happened. Loosey-goosey. You ever see in a pool hall where a guy, he's a magician, throw $10 on the thing, and he tightens right up? Well, what happens? They're loosey-goosey. Let's go. Let's win. Let's say, hey, ho. Whoa, we get a little close now. Hey, we got a chance here. As soon as they say a little chance, coaches change a little. We got a chance, and that's what happens all the time. Down the stretch, they're great. Comes the big meat ones, gone. That's what happens every time.
What do you think happened with Patrick?
You know, here's the funny thing. Patrick and Jonathan, if you could talk to them right now, I know they wish this never happened. But, you know, I'm not giving you an excuse. Don't say you make an excuse. I'm going to tell you what happened. These are volatile, as you would say. Patrick, Jonathan, they're getting hammered. I think it ended up 10-1, and that's what happened. You run up a score. You know, it's so sad when you see this. Now we got politicians in it. They're going to ban fighting out of junior. They're going to do this. Now, folks, listen to me. I played for the Windsor Spitfires. I played for the Barry, and we won the Memorial Cup, and I coached junior. You cannot ban fighting out of junior hockey. And I'll tell you why. And David Branch and everybody should look. I was in it. I played it. I coached it. You have 20-year-olders in the league, and you have 16-year-olders in the league. The 16-year-olders are dynamite, or they wouldn't be there. Now, usually the older guys will leave the younger guys alone until you get, if you're going to make the playoffs or something like that. If it means the playoffs, some of these big guys go after. They got nothing to lose, the overage or something. They go after these young guys. If you don't have somebody to step in and take a charge and keep those guys off it, those 16-year-olders will be open season. Now, you don't know as much as me about junior hockey. I played it and coached it.
Hey, listen, the problem is Patrick's, you know, actions are bordering like on pathological, right? He's been in trouble so often that he's, unfortunately, he's invited this investigation.
You're absolutely right, and this hurts hockey. You cannot believe in Patrick. He got, if you're watching, I know you're watching, smarten up and stop that. You're going to ruin your chances to coach the National Hockey League. You know, I got to say something, okay? We get Pronger 8 games. We get 55 games for Simon. And we get for Jonathan, we get 8. 63-game suspension. You know how many games the other team, the victims? Nothing. Nothing. By the way, I don't understand that other goalie. You see him coming 60 feet. You know, he wasn't coming down for a chat. Anyhow.
Well, he's their number one.
I mean,
Jonathan's
the
backup. I don't know a lot about it except to say that they need him. So
I know, but once it starts.
I often wonder, too, where do the officials go?
Well, I don't want to show it because I don't, you know, you're a referee, but there was a guy going to the kid's rescue and the linesman stopped him. Figure that one out. If you don't believe me, I'll show it to you. Anyhow, all those suspensions, nobody hurt. I do something. Frost, this kid may never play again. Still in the hospital.
Foster.
And not Foster. Foster for sure. He was their third best defenseman. He goes on the power play. He might never play again. And nothing. Nobody says a word about it. Unbelievable to me. But don't start taking. We don't want politicians mixed up in hockey. All right?
It is funny because, you know, I was saying to you, the bullfighting, bull riders, deaths in rodeo every year, car crashes, skiers go down. But for some reason, it's hockey. It's our
our sport.
And you worry. People do worry about their kids. But what you said is a good defense.
You can't. You get 16. You're the young ones are the stars.
The junior A that I ref, the only time I ever had to kick out a coach was Tony in Fort Erie because he got a 16-year-old got beat up and he was hot at the linesman.
When I see a 16-year-old kid getting smacked around, I saw a guy named Shrimp. Remember Bobby Schmidt? He got He got smashed in the boards, had a concussion, didn't play. 16-year-olders. You got to have somebody take care of him. Don't be dummies.
Yeah.
All right.
Patrick's going to learn, hopefully, from this.
He'll learn.
This.
Don't worry. That's it, Patrick. No more of that stuff.
Okay, let's go with there's a couple of incidents from the Minnesota Wild. I want to start with Jeff Cowan coming in on Bugard
Don't. Wait a minute. Let me just set this up. Folks, every once in a while, I watch TV, and I say, I want that guy in the trench with me in a war. And I'll tell you, that Cowan, to me, if Vancouver had the heart here, wait a minute. Now, watch Bugard. He doesn't want to fight him. It's Vieska here. But watch this Cowan. This Bugard is 6'7", 260. Watch this Cowan. He wants, but Bugard is a good guy. He's honorable. He doesn't want to go with him because he's smaller. Of course, everybody's smaller. But watch, he could annihilate him if he wanted to, but he's just kind of holding him. Okay, you know what? I'll give you a couple of shots, he said, to hold him down. Now, folks, to me, that's honor and that's courage. The courage is Cowan, and the honor is Bugard. And you people want to take this out. That no way Bugard was going to hurt him because you know why? He admired him. Mm-hmm. He admired him, and that's courage. And you people want to take it out. All right.
And the other example you have is Jacques Lemaire was really happy with Todd Fedor.
Now, listen, let me tell you something. Wait a minute. You got to come back to me. You got to watch this. You got to. There's guys. Well, anyhow, watch this now. Watch. Gaborik's there. Watch Fedor come in now. Watch him come in. Guy knows he's got to protect the scores and that. He doesn't throw in anything. Now, come back to me. Come back to me. Now, you know that Jacques Lemaire, that he has coached more and played more than anybody in the history of the game. Coach of the year, Stanley Cup winner, the whole deal. He knows what's going on. Gaborik, believe it or not, scored 5 goals. I saw the game. He never even looked at him. Never said a word to him. He kind of, you know, he's a sourpuss sort of guy. Now, wait a minute. Don't show it yet. Watch what he does when Fedoruk skates off the ice. I couldn't believe it. Now, watch.
It's a cartwheel by his standards.
Yeah, that is what you'll never... Isn't that great? And look, he goes off like a gladiator, everybody. You people don't know. There's coach of the year. I tell you, you got to have the protectors.
Attacks on hockey up the yin-yang. It's the Tao of Cowan, as opposed to Cowtown from Don in the Coach's Corner. Hockey Night in Canada.